Greetings, brothers. My name is Dalton Hughes, Bosses of Theta Chi Chapter of Omega Sci-Fi, and welcome to our 66th annual anniversary celebration. Here at Theta Chi, we believe in manhood, scholarship, perseverance, and uplift. Also, friendship. Friendship is essential to the soul. Again, thank you to the guests, and welcome. We hope you enjoy the program.
Greetings, brother. My name is William Anderson. I go back to 168 Theta Chi. My line was the Funky Four. And I didn't, you know, lo and behold, back then, I didn't really have a line name. They didn't really push a line name back in the day. During those early years, and I have really come to embrace what the younger brothers are doing today. And when I say the younger brothers, I have to more or less go back to Rho Theta, because like I said, we were undergraduates, but we had to pledge through the graduate chapter because there was no undergraduate chapter at PV. But I have to admire what the younger brothers today are doing, not so much as Rho Theta being the undergrads, but also the younger brothers that come into Theta Chi. They come in more or less now with a purpose and commitment to do things, because when you get on the graduate level, it's about community service. It's really about community service.
Greetings, brothers. My name is Lawrence A. Allen Jr., 11 Rho Theta, 82. My line name happens to be Papa Smurf, but most people know me as Scully. Now, I've been asked to talk about the chapter from 1985 to 1990, and it is truly an honor for me to talk about this history in a succinct way. In 1985, I was in graduate school, and so I then left after I received my master's and went on to Houston. And that was a growth in Houston of chapters coming online. In 1985, Rho Beta Beta was chartered. And so a number of brothers and younger brothers, they called it a intermediate chapter, a division of coming out of Nu Phi, our historical chapter, our oldest chapter in the area, the birth of Rho Beta Beta. And so I joined Rho Beta Beta, and there were two brothers in Rho Beta Beta that were from Rho Theta. And I thought that was kind of odd that only two brothers were active during that time period for my chapter. In Nu Phi, there may have been one, maybe two brothers from Rho Theta, and they were from the early 70s that were active in the fraternity. And so I thought that was a space missing. Rho Xi was coming online, and they were also meeting in Houston as well, in the Hiram Clark area of Houston. And so, but most of the brothers were from Phi Beta that were a member of Rho Xi. And it was a small chapter, maybe 12 brothers were in the chapter, and no brothers were from Rho Theta were active in that particular chapter. So I was quite puzzled that we didn't have a space or a place where there was a representation of the brothers who were initiated in Prairie View in the graduate chapters in Houston at the time. And so there was a brother by the name of Joe Kelly. Joe Kelly was initiated spring of 82 in Prairie View, and he was living in Conroe. And he wanted to talk about getting the brothers active again in the fraternity. And so we said, well, let's go and join Theta Chi. And then we could have reunions and be around the university and see the other brothers. And so he says, okay, let's go and see when they're gonna have a meeting. So he and I went to Prairie View to hang out with the brothers and discovered at that time period that the chapter was not functioning. It was around 1987 at that time. And the chapter had been given a suspension for not paying the assessment on the new National Center that we have in Atlanta. All chapters were asked to pay a service fee. Every undergraduate chapter and the graduate chapters had to pay $500. And if you hadn't paid the $500 by a particular time, they removed your chapter and called it inactive for that very simple reason. And so once we discovered that the chapter was inactive and that there was a need to reactivate it with $500, we got in touch with the Keeper of Finance for the 9th District. He was living in Beaumont. And you can imagine, we had to drive to Beaumont to take this money. I don't know why we couldn't cash app it then and all those kinds of things. But Joe Kelly and I drove to Beaumont and we paid $500. He and I split the $500. You can imagine we were very excited. It was 1987 going into the 98 year. And we were excited to return to Prairie View and inform the brothers in the Prairie View area that the chapter was up and viable again, and we can begin to function in the fraternity.
All right, I'm here to talk about the 90s. I was made in Theta Chi in the spring of 90. Our line name was The New Beginning because we had been out of existence for a few years in Theta Chi. And the brothers had worked to get us back active, and we the first line for a little while since the 84 line. My line name was Tip Pup. I had four line brothers. One is deceased now. WJ has been deceased about close to 15 years. WJ Sinet. It was Vernon Matthews was the ace, Chester was the deuce, WJ was the tray, and I was the tail. Thing about when we came along, the chapter was actually in Prairie View, and most of the brothers in Prairie View was trying to move the chapter to Houston. Well, not so much move to Houston, but they were meeting in Houston. And it had been kind of dormant for a few years, and they did everything to get us back acclimated with our IHQ. And then we got online. It took us a little while, but we got online. And I can remember brothers like Scully, James Scott, Caleb Anderson, Ricky Anderson, Frank Woodson. It was a lot of them that did a lot of work to get the chapter back going. I mean, you know, it was a lot of old brothers in Prairie View that were, you know, pretty old, and they were just kind of out of the loop and didn't have a lot of dealings with the chapter, with the Omega as a whole. They were, you know, late in age, so they didn't have a lot of activities going on, so they fought them a little bit about moving the chapter to Houston. I mean, not so much move to Houston. I guess they promised them they would meet in Prairie View a couple of times a year, which we still do, but I guess they just didn't want to see it leave Prairie View. They felt like they was taken out of Prairie View. They really wasn't, but we met here in Houston because most of the brothers lived in Houston.
Good evening, bros. Marvin Cassex, 5, Theta Chi 2002, 7 Sons of Controversy. I was asked to speak to the chapter on the year 2000 and 2010. As I just stated, I was initiated in 2002, so I'm gonna start at that point. 2002, when I came in, we were under the leadership of Sir Jackson. Sir Jackson was our boss at that time. As a matter of fact, he was also our MSP chair. So we came in under Sir Jackson as well. Frat meetings were held. Brothers, I'm not too sure the older brothers know this, but we didn't used to have frat meetings at the frat house. Our frat meetings were held at office on Hornwood, I believe that was, the Southwest Houston. It was Sir Jackson's aunt's medical office. So we actually went over there along with two other chapters, undergraduate chapters, Ada Mu and Rho Theta, in 2002. Our meetings were held there. We did interest meetings there. Everything was pretty much held in that area. also in 2002 under Sir's administration, we received an award for chapter of the year. After Sir's term was over, Brother Kenneth Broughton took office. From that period, we moved from having frat meetings from Sirius Hunt's place to Darren Lewis's clubhouse.
After Brother
Sexy's big brother Ken Broughton's term, Rodney Lewis came in, and right around that time, I want to say 2006, 2007, that's where we created TOMAC, which is our 501(c)(3), our nonprofit. So we started playing around with that. We created TOMAC, and we also started getting into our bylaws. Excuse me. We started updating our bylaws. One of the most important things that we did to the bylaws is generally we used to have members interested in Theta Chi, and we'd have some brothers that would were non-financial, and they would get financial just so they can bring in members. So one of the updates we did to the bylaws, and I believe this was in Brother Rodney Lewis's administration, we made it so that brothers that were financing, you were sponsoring a potential, you'd have to be financial with the chapter for at least 2 years, and they play key.
Before we go any further, let's be.
17 Sons of Redemption, line name Bang Bang. My topic is, what does it mean to be a proud member of Theta Chi? And it's a lot of things to mention, but I'll start with the fact that initially, it's because of the birth attachment to Prairie View A&M University. There's a lot of pride in history at Prairie View, and I happen to have the pleasure of being a part of that for 3 years, and had a lot of personal growth and development to Prairie View. So, and that's where I first got exposed to the Omega Psi Phi fraternity, was at Prairie View. So what I saw and what was attractive to me at that time happened at Prairie View. And so that's the first portion. That's my pride of Prairie View. It's part of my pride in Theta Chi. The other piece is what I've learned about the importance and significance of being a member or being made in a Theta Chi chapter. Once I started seeking Theta Chi with intention, I learned more and more about the integrity or the fabric of what's the baseline of this chapter. And it's the friendship, which is synonymous with the fraternity as well, friendship. And I think Theta Chi does it head and shoulders above everyone else. We've been blessed to have a lineage of brotherhood in the Theta Chi chapter that extends past 50 years. So to have 5 decades of brotherhood and exposed to that at a close level, I think it means a lot to the traditions of the chapter as it relates to the fraternity as a whole. The involvement and the commitments to our mandated programs and the community service events that we are committed to, there's not just a handful of individuals doing the bulk of the work. You could look at it as the 80-20 rule, but I think our percentage is a lot greater than that. And I would say that at either rate, whatever the numbers are, we're touching and tangibly touching and embracing a lot of issues in our community as a chapter and involving ourselves with everything that the fraternity is supporting or the initiatives that the fraternity has at the national level. We have some tenured brothers in our chapters that really take pride in making sure we understand that in getting past the moniker of being a Q-Dog, there's a certain pride you should feel in saying, I am an Omega man. I am a member of Omega Psi Phi fraternity, not just a Q-Dog. When we do things, we try to do things with a level of excellence and a presentation that speaks not only highly of our chapter, but in how we employ ourselves to represent the fraternity as a whole. And you learned the importance of our brand in Omega through activities like that allow you to be as involved and as an opportunity to make change, a vehicle of change, that you can't help but establish a level of pride with that. The significance of the examples of work we service, the work and service that we do is not only important, but we take pride in that. We take heavy pride. We collaborate with other chapters in Houston as a whole. But the friendship bond in everything that we do is just phenomenal. You really can't put words to it. And so my pride in Theta Chi at the highest level is because in the midst of a herd of Theta Chi made Omegas or members of the Theta Chi chapter, the extended hand of friendship is boundless. And
I have examples of individuals that live their creed in the world of Omega that I'm proud to be in brotherhood with at a close level. So definitely the immediate attachment to Prayer View and the example of friendship within the chapter at a high standard.
Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard that went down to the skirts of his garments, as the dew of Hermon and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessings, even life forevermore.
Why must I feel like that?